have a long experience in working in infra companies. What do you think of the key trends there to move forward?
Basically, if you see the last 2-3 years times built by the new government of India, government has moved first online sector. And every year they are increasing the budget allocation for infra projects. If you will see the last budget, around 11 lakh crores, they are planning to invest in the infrastructure. So going forward, the growth in the infrastructure sector will be massive growth. And if you will see the development in terms of road sector, power sector, in terms of airport sector and port sector, the manifold growth have been seen in the past, and it is expected that by 2030, the spending on the infrastructure will be around one trillion rupees by the government of India. So the present government, and I am expecting that the future government will also keep spending on the infrastructure. That will be drive the growth for the country, that will drive growth for the future of the country. And as far as the government target to be the 5 trillion economy, Infra will play a key role in the government, in the development of the country and development of the people of the country.
Great. You have a deep perspective on financial reporting. What do you think is the state of financial reporting in our corporation?
Basically, if you will see the past trends, the financial institute of Chartered Accountants of India and many other institutions have now set financial reporting patterns, financial reporting guidelines, and all the infrastructure companies now following that guidelines, and auditors also looking into it and doing their assignment, doing their audits as per the guidelines set by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and any institute which are into the financial reporting or financial reporting sector. So gradually the quality of the financial reporting is improving day by day, and it is expected that it will further improve to as part of the global reporting.
What's your view on real estate, particularly in infra and real estate?
Basically, real estate sector was down a little bit in past so many years, mainly because of the increase in the cost of the raw materials. If you see post-COVID, the cost of raw material has gone up by around 30-50%, like steel, cement, labor cost also. So that phase is now over, and going forward the real estate sector is also improved rapidly, and this cooling of the cost, raw material cost, is now started. So there is a stability of the price of the raw material, so that will impact the positive, that will have positive impact on the margin of the real estate company. So as per my view, experience, all the real estate companies, all the real estate sector as well will improve.
Despite the commodity prices are rising?
Commodity prices are rising, but it will not have steep rising. It will have impact 10%, 20% on the cost. Not 60% on the cost, which has impacted in the past 2-3 years.
It will be stable also.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for
your time. I also want to thank you. I also want to add basically I was an infrastructure company for last 20 years with my experience. Now I have started my own venture. I am into the entrepreneurship and I am supporting companies in the infrastructure in arranging debts, arranging funds, and also arranging equity for their projects.
You also work in the hotel sector?
Yeah, I also have worked on the funding arrangement.